celebrate the feast of the presentation of Christ in the temple. And we begin that by remaining standing to sing together our opening hymn, hymn number 391. That we celebrate this evening, that of the presentation of Christ in the temple, actually falls on the 2nd of February in each year, and thereby marks the end of what is known as the great 40 days of Christmas, the end of the church's celebration of the birth of Christ. And on Christmas Day, as we celebrate his birth, today we celebrate his appearing in the temple, in the arms of Mary and Joseph, to be presented in the temple in Jerusalem as according to the laws and traditions of the Jewish people. And it was at that meeting that the aged Simeon saw the Christ and held him in his arms. It was at that meeting that Anna the prophetess was able to say that here is someone who is not only very special, but is the greatest, the Son of God, and come as the Redeemer, as the Saviour. And then the other part of this festival, which is today a festival of light, is then looking toward Lent, to Holy Week and Easter, the Passion of Christ before the glory of the Resurrection. But today we celebrate, as did Simeon long ago. And the choir will sing as they do Sunday by Sunday those matchless words, Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word. These are the words given Simeon in the temple long ago. We turn now to our orders of service in the chapel service book and to page 9. Beloved, we are come together in the presence of Almighty God and of the whole company of heaven to offer unto him through our Lord Jesus Christ our worship and praise and thanksgiving, to make confession of our sins, to pray as well for others as for ourselves, that we may know more truly the greatness of God's love and show forth in our lives the fruits of his grace, and to ask on behalf of all people such things as their well-being doth require. Wherefore, let us kneel in silence and remember God's presence with us now. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And there is no health in us. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare thou them, O God, which confess their faults. Restore thou them that are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind, in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. May the Almighty and merciful Lord grant unto you pardon and remission of all your sins, time for amendment of life, and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. For this evening is Psalm number 24, and you'll find that on page 143 in the chapel service books, and we are seated for the psalm and stand for the Gloria.
Thank you. Since the children have flesh and blood, he too shared in their humanity, so that by his death he might break the power of him who holds the power over death, that is, the devil, and free those who all their lives were held in slavery by their fear and death. For surely it is not the angel he helps, but Abraham's descendants. For this reason he has been made to be like them, fully human in every way, in order that he might become a merciful and faithful high priest in service to God, and that he might make atonement for the sins of the people, because he himself suffered when he was tempted. He is able to help those who are being tempted.
Thank you. The second lesson is taken from Luke chapter 2, verses 22 to 40. When the time came for the purification rites required by the law of Moses, Joseph and Mary took him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male is to be consecrated to the Lord and to offer a sacrifice in keeping with what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon, who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple courts. When the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what the custom of the law required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you may now dismiss your servant in peace. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all nations, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel." The child's father and mother marveled at what was said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "This child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thoughts of many hearts will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was very old. She had lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage, and then was a widow until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshipped night and day, fasting and praying. Coming up to them at their very moment, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were looking forward to the redemption of Jerusalem. When Joseph and Mary had done everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. And the child grew and became strong. He was filled with wisdom, and the grace of God was on him. Here ends the second lesson.
in the face of Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
The anthem, familiar words, "When to the Temple Mary Went," in a new setting this evening, composed by our very own director of music, Mr. Robinson, and is being sung for the first time this evening.
Let us pray. To God, whose love to all that he made him beyond measure, make your church always worthy of her calling as the bride of Christ. Give to all Christian people the virtues of faith and purity that shall show your glory before the world. Bless the love which brings men and women together in a new unity. Be near to those soon to be married or recently married, and give them grace to continue in love and loyalty to the end of their lives. Come with your generous care into our homes and into all the homes in this community. Bless the mothers who are careful for so many needs, and refresh them when they are weary. Look with mercy on those homes where love is threatened by poverty. Support and strengthen the parents who struggle to provide for their children. We rejoice as a community of believers, and we pray to worthy of all of your calling. Amen.
Stand now to sing the offertory hymn, hymn number 393. Peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you this night and always. Amen.
Amen.